going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, is another edition of Movie Review Wednesday, and today we got a doozy for you. We have a doozy. I just got back from the theater a few hours ago and watched this amazing movie, and I will be reviewing it today. It is Deadpool 2. What can you really say? The first Deadpool was fantastic. It was hilarious. This one lived up to the hype, if not more. So basically, the whole backstory of this is you got Deadpool, Wade Wilson, back having a great time. You know, he's gone international doing some stuff in different countries, comes back, has his anniversary with his girlfriend, I believe, still Vanessa. I don't think they're married. I have no idea. You know, they're talking about, they're having a good time, they're just chilling, talking about starting a family, and then all of a sudden they get ambushed. And Wade kills like everyone except for one guy, and the one guy shoots Vanessa and she dies. And basically what this whole the whole story is him trying to essentially die and go to heaven and be with her, because he just can't take it anymore. He has no family to go to or anything. So he tries that, he doesn't die, he grows back, and then he becomes an X-Men for like a short time. And there's this whole incident with this guy, Russell, or Firefist. He's one of the mutants at this mutant school. And he just goes berserk and blah, blah, blah. Deadpool goes berserk, shoots one of the people from the school because they were abusing the kid. And they both go to jail. And in this whole time, we have the villain Cable, played by Josh Brolin, a.k.a. Thanos, coming from the future to come and try to find Russell or Firefist, because he is the reason why his family is dead. So they're in jail. Josh Brolin storms in. They have a big fight. And yeah, that's that. Josh Brolin and Wade go flying out of the jail. Deadpool says some very questionable things, which makes Russell not like him anymore. So they leave. So then they're gone. And they're trying to stop Cable from getting to Russell, so Deadpool creates X-Force. And the funny thing about X-Force is he creates a huge team, and they all die, like, right away. Like, right away, they're all dead. Except for Domino. And yeah, that's it. Domino. The rest are dead. So that's really sad. And so they have, like, all these fight scenes with Josh Brolin and blah, 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 blah. Juggernaut comes in and is with Firefist and splits Wade in half, so Wade just has his upper torso and he has to grow his legs back and stuff, which is just hilarious. But then Cable comes to the, he needs help from Deadpool and Domino and, you know, X-Force. He needs their help. So what they end up doing is they end up confronting Russell as he's just going berserk, and they end up stopping him from becoming this killer that the future was told that he would become. And you can tell by the teddy bear that Cable has, which is his daughter's, it was all fried and charcoaled from what Russell had done in the future, and then it just turned back to normal, which means that Russell never ended up killing him, which is great. But in the process of that, Wade ends up taking a bullet for Russell, and he ends up dying and going to heaven, and he finally gets to his happy place with Vanessa. But Vanessa says, no, it's not your time yet. And what happens is Cable goes back in time, puts something in Deadpool's like little jacket area where the bullet goes, and it stops the bullet. And so Deadpool actually ends up surviving. So Deadpool goes back. And it's a happy ending. It's great. I really love this movie. Oh, and then you have the scene at the end. The credits where Deadpool takes Cable's time travel machine, goes back and saves Vanessa. And it's all happy again. So it kind of completely undid whatever happened in Deadpool 2. But honestly, I wasn't that peed off about it like a lot of people were. A lot of people were really mad about it, but I honestly thought it was great because I thought that the journey itself was a lot of fun. So I thought this movie was fantastic. I loved it. It was, in my opinion, better than the first one, which is the complete opposite of what most people are saying. A lot of people are saying the first one's better, but I think the second one was by far better. It was way funnier, in my opinion. There were a lot more laugh out loud moments. I had so many moments where I just laughed out loud in the theater that I didn't do during the first Deadpool. The first Deadpool was funny, but this one I think was just like leaps and bounds funnier, in my opinion. So my grade, I gave it a 9 out of 10. I was going to give it 8.5, but I was like, you know what? It just pushes it over just a little bit. Gave it a 9 out of 10. If you have not seen it in theaters, go see it. Let me know down below what you guys thought of Deadpool 2. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Would you recommend people go see it in theaters? I thought it was such a funny movie. It was just so great. And there was even a part where Deadpool made a comment about, he called Cable Thanos. He's like, okay, Thanos, like, stop, or something like that. I don't remember what the exact line was, but it's hilarious because Cable's played by Josh Brolin, who plays Thanos. It was just so funny. But yeah, that's pretty much it. If you guys enjoyed, please like, comment, subscribe. Go check out Deadpool 2. And of course, again, let me know down in the comments down below, what did you think of Deadpool 2? If you have seen it, did you like it? Did you hate it? I'd love to hear from you. Let me know down below. But of course, that's it. Thank you for watching. We'll see you later for another video. And have a great rest of your day.